Hi everybody, thank you for coming back to Canine IQ. The video today is all about the introduction of a release cue and a continuation cue in the training of puppies. Stay tuned. The first part of this video is all about introducing a release cue into your puppy's training, but more importantly, to get an understanding of why release cues are really important for a puppy to understand the sequence of how to problem solve within training. So I'll break this down into all the different sections that we need to apply, and then I'll demonstrate it on a puppy for you. Let's look at the whole release command in a lot more detail. So the first thing that we need to come to terms with is we need to pick a word that effectively tells the puppy or the dog that the exercise that it's currently doing is over and it can get up out of that position. So a lot of people pick words like okay or go, and they are just words that happen way too often in the context of normal conversation. So the dog could inadvertently pick up on the discussion in the background because it's heard that particular noise. So if we pick a word that actually produces a mental image of what it is that we want the dog to do, and it doesn't happen that often, it's more likely to be more specific. And words like free, play, party, finish, over, game, chill are great words, as long as it's the same word every single time that tells the puppy that that exercise is finished. So the way that the process goes is we need to start the whole exercise by giving the dog an instruction. And in the video that will follow this, you'll see that I'll give the puppy an instruction to sit. The puppy sits. And you'll also notice that I don't give the puppy the reward as soon as it sits. Now, this is really important because I want the puppy to figure out, hey, where's my reward? When's it coming? And if we get the puppy to start to learn that it has to begin an exercise like sit, do some work in order to get the reward and then be released out of that sit to get the reward, its whole mindset to working is geared around trying to find a solution. So when the puppy's in that sit, what we're trying to do is to wait for the puppy to give us firstly compliance, which basically means it actually does the task that we want it to do. And ideally we can start to get the puppy used to being calm and relaxed and learning how to introduce self-control to get to the end of the exercise. And self-control in puppies, those of you that have got one, know that it's probably the last thing on their mind and it's the first thing that we actually need to start to teach them. So when the puppy's actually nice and calm and it's reached the part of the exercise that we're happy with, so it's calm and it's complied with the sit, we then introduce that release word. So we might say that word free, and then the puppy hears that word and it starts to respond accordingly. So what we need to do then is to encourage the puppy out of the sit to follow us out of that sit. And then when it's physically moving out of that sit, we introduce the desired reward that we want. So if we're training with food, then and only then do we give it the reward. If we're training with affection or a pat, we can then pick the puppy up and give it a big hug. If we're training with tug of war or balls, then we can throw the ball or play tug of war. So the puppy starts to realize, when you give me that word sit, I need to do it, I need to calm down, I need to wait for you to say that release command, and then when you said it, the reward comes. Now the silent benefit of having a release command is then you don't need to say words like wait or stay, because if I tell you sit, the only way you get out of that sit is if I say free, in which case stay and wait become irrelevant words. So in effect, we're having to teach the puppy less words to understand the process. Let's have a look at the video and see if it makes more sense.
So I'm going to give him one instruction.
Sit.
Just like you would normally do it, right? And in the early stages, I don't want him to wait too long. And then free, and encourage him out of that sit and he gets his food. If you're not using food, you can encourage him out of that sit,
give him a cuddle.
Him up and give him a cuddle. Let him out of that sit, throw the tennis ball.
Okay.
Let him out of that sit, get into the car. Let him out of that sit, get into the house. All these different things.
Yep.
We'll do it again. Sit. And then I'm just trying to wait a little bit longer because I'm just trying to stretch his brain a little bit. I might need to let him see this again so he remembers what he's supposed to be doing. So I'm trying to count to 10, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Puppy.
Free. Good boy.
And then he gets food.
In this part of the video, we'll be talking about the introduction of a continuation cue, which, unlike a release cue, which ends the exercise, a continuation cue is effective information that tells the puppy that it needs to keep doing the task that it's doing in order to reach the eventual success and release, which is a very important tool to help the puppy learn how to problem solve within the sit itself. And again, I'll explain it and then demonstrate it with another puppy. This part of the video is all about understanding a process whereby we get the puppy to learn how to sit longer, and for us to give the puppy feedback that the behavior that it's actually giving us in terms of problem solving while it's doing that sit is heading in the right direction. So in order for this to happen, we start off with the sit the way we did before. So we give a clear instruction for the puppy to sit, it goes into the sit, and then when the puppy is in that sit, what we're trying to do is to actually build a longer version of it. So at the first part, we tried to get the puppy to comply first and then to be a bit calm, and what we're trying to do is to extend it. So in the early stages, it might have been the puppy sitting for 5 seconds, and then we might try and get the puppy to sit for 10 seconds or 20 or 30 or 40, or maybe introduce a little bit of a distraction and get the puppy to resist it. So the puppy needs to understand that when it's in that sit, it effectively has to concentrate and start to prioritize some information, like, do I look at the things that are going on around me? Do I give in to impulsive behavior? Or do I sit and concentrate on the task that's at hand? And the introduction of a continuation cue helps the puppy to stay on target. So when we introduce a continuation cue, it's effectively information that we're giving to the puppy that it's doing the right thing. So it may be in that sit, and it's holding that sit. So simply introducing a phrase like good boy, or if you're using a clicker to mark that behavior, is feedback to the puppy that it's actually doing the desired behavior. However, it hasn't quite reached the end of the process. And that only happens when we reach the end of how long we want the puppy to sit for, and then we introduce the release cue. But initially, it's just a way of saying to the puppy, keep going, you haven't reached the end yet, continue what you are doing, you are heading in the right direction. When the puppy has achieved that, so say the target was getting the puppy to sit for 10 seconds and be calm, and it's achieved that, then we can introduce that release command that we did before, the word free. We then encourage the puppy out of that sit once again. And then when the puppy's physically moving out of that sit, we continue with the desired reward method that we had before. So if you're using food or balls or tug of war, we still maintain that. So the puppy learns, I'm in a sit, I have to sit, wait to be released, but you'll give me information along the way to tell me that I'm doing the right behavior. And when I've achieved that level of success, you will say the release command again, which is the same word that you used before, and I get success out of it. It's really important because we're consistent in every aspect. Let's have a look at the video and break it down.
Sit. Now see, at the moment it's important because I've told him sit and he's visually interested in this. Good boy. So good boy in this situation means you're heading in the right direction, but the game's not over. Sit. See how he's moving? He's trying to figure out what's happening next. Now he's thinking.
Free.
Right? So I'm giving him that release command, and then he can physically get out of that sit and try and find where the food is. So what I'm trying to do from minute one in the training is switch on his thinking. Sit.
This is a bonus video showing an alternative way to reward the puppy after the release command, and it's using tug of war as a primary reward.
So this is how we use a rag to stimulate the whole predatory behavior and to help with the mouthing and biting. And the T-tail is a good thing. So what I want to do is just want to get him used to this. Right? I want to build this interest in it. Right, and this is why this is much better than a rope toy, because I'm getting the dog interested in biting, right? And if he's, once he starts to get a good sit, I go, sit, sit,
free.
Right, so that I introduce that release command, and that free means, ooh, I can bite that now. I can get the food through, I can get a pat, right?
Thank you for making it through to the end. So let's do a bit of a summary so that we all leave on a happy footing. So the first thing that we need to do is to make sure that if we're giving the puppy an instruction like sit, it needs to be clear, it needs to be calm, needs to be non-threatening, so the puppy understands that's the job that you want me to do and I'm happy to comply with it. The next thing that we need to do is, while the puppy's in that sit, we need to start to make the puppy think. And that's really important from very minute one. Get the puppy thinking, and then we can continuously push the puppy harder and harder so that every time we do the sit, it actually works harder than the previous time. And this is important because puppies have got a great brain. We need to stimulate them and make them work. Once the puppy's actually doing that behavior, we can then introduce what we call a continuation cue, which basically gives the puppy feedback that the behavior that it's doing is exactly what we want it to do, and it gains confidence in making that good decision to actually follow instructions and show self-control and actually carry out the task. So it's really good feedback for the puppy to have. Then when the puppy has reached the point of success, which is when we are happy with the process or what it's actually offering us, we can introduce that release command free, or whatever word that we're using, to tell the puppy that, hey, the exercise is finished. You are now free to be a puppy again and do what you want to do. And then we can reward the puppy with whatever methodology you want, whether it's balls, whether it's food, tug of war, affection, whatever. It's up to you, as long as we're consistent in rewarding the desired behavior. Hope you found the video useful. Thanks again for all your time and effort. Appreciate it.